Well, reports suggest that Punjab State Power Distribution Company has agreed to revise the tariff plan for Tata Power's Mundra unit. Of course, the Rajasthan DISCOM is expected to follow suit anytime soon. And of course, we also have the state of Maharashtra and Haryana currently under elections. But the expectation is that post the elections, there could be, some positive news with respect to the Tata Power's Mundra power purchase agreement. The Tata unit, which is currently facing an under-recovery of 50 paise per kilowatt hour, around that mark. And the revised power purchase agreements will surely make up for some bit of the shortfall. Let's ask Praveer Sinha, Managing Director and CEO at Tata Power, about this development. Thank you, Mr. Sinha, for speaking to Bloomberg Quint and taking out your time. Let me begin by asking you with the arrangement for the Mundra power plant. Recently the Punjab government, the cabinet, as well as the state DISCOM have approved, the new plan. How really will this benefit Tata Power, and are the terms in line with what the Gujarat government did for the Mundra power unit?
Good morning, and thank you, Neeraj, for having me on the show. As you rightly mentioned, that Punjab DISCOM has agreed. Of course, it has to still go to the cabinet and get it approved, which we expect to happen in next few weeks' time. And once the Punjab cabinet approval comes, then I'm expecting even Rajasthan to clear it. In fact, the process is going on at present in Rajasthan, and hopefully in next few weeks we expect their decision. And post-elections, both Haryana and Maharashtra should be able to clear the proposal, because there is a general consensus amongst all the buyers of power that even with the revised tariff, it would still be in merit order, and it makes sense for them to continue procuring power from here. Otherwise, the power that they would have alternately gone and procured would have been much more expensive. So I think it's a win-win for everyone, and we are expecting that in next few months they should get concluded, not only at the state government level, but also at the CERC level, and we should be moving ahead from there on.
Okay. And Mr. Sinha, the terms for the revised PPA and the compensatory tariff remain similar for Gujarat as well as Punjab, right? So there is no changes that have been made by Punjab with respect to the PPA. Will it be similar to what Gujarat did, just to understand if there is any difference between the arrangements?
There are certain minor modifications to the terms that was approved by Gujarat based on the HPC report, but those are not really moving the needle in terms of the realization. And as this is a common PPA, whatever is agreed with Punjab will also be applicable to Gujarat and other states. So it's a common terms that will be applicable to all the procurers. And we expect that the guidelines which have been given by HPC and which has been accepted by Gujarat, more or less on those lines itself, it will get accepted.
Okay, good to know that. And Mr. Sinha, you were mentioning that Maharashtra as well as Haryana are most likely to also conclude a transaction or a deal with respect to the revised PPA for Mundra post the elections. Hopefully that happens. But in terms of timelines, do you think, before the fiscal year closes, both these states would be on board and, the approvals would be granted probably in the period of next two quarters?
Yeah, that's what our expectation is, because Maharashtra also, the cabinet note has been made. It has been cleared by the respective government departments of finance and energy. And we expect that once the new government is in place, it should be able to take it to the cabinet and get a concurrence. We also expect that based on the concurrence, all the states will inform and file a petition before the CERC, and that approval should also happen within this financial year, and that's what we are working towards.
Okay. And with respect to the effectiveness of, the entire change in PPA which has been made, will it be retrospective, probably from October 2018 or, will it differ from state to state?
Well, the HPC recommended that it should be effective 15th October 2018. This was a part of the settlement process wherein we agreed that it will be not a retrospective effect from the commissioning of the plant, and that losses will be borne by the project developers. So we expect that it will be effective from 15th October 2018, and whatever is the impact because of that, we will get that once it is decided.
Okay. Sir, shifting focus from Mundra to the non-renewable part of your business, can you give us an idea as to what are the new developments here? Recently in September, you announced that you commissioned almost 150 megawatts of solar power units. And also, when I was having a chat with Tata Motors, they were also talking about the venture in which and the ecosystem in which the Tata Group can set up charging infrastructure for electric vehicles, and Tata Power will play a big role. So if you could just give us an idea, what are the expansion plans in the renewable space as well as in the electric vehicle charging infrastructure?
As far as renewable is concerned, we are about 2600 megawatt in renewable, out of which about 1500 is solar. We recently commissioned a 200 megawatt plant, and we have another 600 odd megawatt which is under implementation, and in next 6 to 12 months they will get completed. And we have decided that we will be focusing on renewable projects in future, because that's the way the technology is moving and that's where the market is moving. However, we are very cautious in terms of which states to put projects, what type of projects, and also in terms of what sort of tariff we should bid for, so that it ensures a certain minimum rate of return for our shareholders. So we are going to do it, but we will be very cautious and also measured and moderated in terms of our expectations in the renewable space. As far as the EV charging is concerned, this is again an area where we feel that we are very well equipped, not only in terms of creating the EV infrastructure, but also in terms of sourcing supply of electricity and the consumer benefit in terms of giving them the digital experience of how to use the charging and where to use the charging. So I think we are very convinced about our ability to provide value to our customers. And that's why we have tied up with Tata Motors, and along with Tata Motors, we would be setting up large number of charging stations, both home charging as well as public charging stations. And this would come up in different cities in the country. Apart from that, we are also working with various municipalities. We are working with various of the state governments to see that how both within the city, intra-city as well as intercity, EV charging facilities can be created, whether it is at petrol stations or it is at railway stations or metro stations. And we expect that we'll play a very significant role moving forward in the EV charging ecosystem.
Okay, good to know that. Mr. Sinha, the analyst community did expect that once the Mundra resolution happens, moving forward, a lot of management focus will be on debt reduction. Of course, you have taken initiatives like, selling off your South African mine stake recently in September, in which you garnered nearly 760 crores. But what happens to the rest of the overseas assets and non-core businesses? How is the management really focusing now on debt reduction? And also, if you could update us on the transaction in which is yet to get completed with respect to the Indonesian coal mines stake that you were earlier planning to dispose.
Divestment is one of our core actions which we have taken, and we are working towards that. And in next 6 to 12 months, you will see that many of our international assets which are there, whether it is the Zambian investment or the smaller coal investment that we have in Indonesia or the shipping investments. So some of these investments which are not core to our business, we would be looking at divesting in them. And we are running a proper process so that we get the best returns for our shareholders. And you would see that many of these will happen in next 12 months. Apart from that, we are also looking at getting some of the monies which are stuck up in various places, in especially the Arutmin payment. And there has been very good progress in last 1 year. We've got nearly $90 million. And every month we get about $6 million from the owners over there. So I think overall we will be able to reduce our debt to a very large extent in next 6 months to 12 months time. We also have taken an exercise internally to bring in more efficiency in our operations, and those results also will come in next 6 months to 12 months. So we expect the performance of the company to improve drastically, and sustained operations in our existing businesses will continue to help us to generate enough cash for the growth plans that we have.
Sir, we wish you very best for the same. Thank you so much for speaking to Bloomberg Quint and taking out your valuable time. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So that was the management of Tata Power speaking about the recent resolution efforts that are happening at the Mundra power plant, which are expected to get concluded in the next 6 months or so. Of course, Maharashtra and Haryana will notify the PPA changes very, very shortly post the election. And the management is hopeful that in the next 6 months, there could be some good resolution, post which the focus obviously would remain also on debt reduction. So that's all we have on this special coverage and the chat with Tata Power. We'll take a short break, and on the other side, we'll have more on business news. Stay tuned to Bloomberg Quint.